So welcome to this video. I am Ian Gilfillan from the MariaDB Foundation, and this video looks at the INET6 data type. The INET6 data type is intended to store IPv6 as well as IPv4 addresses. You don't need to know much about IPv6 or IPv4 addresses or even hexadecimal notation to get anything out of this video. It's really about storing and retrieving data from INET6 data types, as well as upgrading from earlier versions of MariaDB that didn't have the INET6 data type. So, let's begin. It's really as simple as creating a table with an INET6 data type and inserting some data into it. So this is an INET6 data type, which is the long text address representation. You can see it's got all the leading zeros, etc. That's a perfectly valid format. We can also store it in the more commonly used short text address notation. And you can see the difference here is that the zero, leading zero, has been removed, and these groups consisting entirely of zeros have been compressed. And you can also store using 16-byte binary string notation, although that is valid. Or you can do the same thing using unhex as well. All of those are valid ways of inserting data. That also accepts IPv4 addresses, something like that. This is IPv4 mapped format. That's also acceptable. And there's also the IPv4 compatible notation. This notation is deprecated, so it's not suggested that you use it. All of those are acceptable formats. And if we select from the table, these are the results that we get back. So on retrieval, INET6 values, you can see, are all converted to the short text representation, that is, with the leading zeros removed and the zero groups compressed. If you do, for some reason, want the long text notation back, you will have to create a stored function to do so. So values are stored as a 16-byte fixed-length binary string with the most significant byte first. Storage engines will see INET6 as binary 16, while clients will see it as char 39, and they get a text representation on retrieval. Even if it's an IPv4 address, mapped or compatible, it will still occupy the full 16 bytes. Right, now INET6 types, you can compare them to another INET6 types in an expression or character string expression, either the long or the short notation, or 16-byte binary string notation. So, for example, here, 16-byte binary string expression, and you get the valid results back. You can also mix INET6 values for result, say in union or coalesce or case then. You can mix it obviously with another INET6 expression or with a character string, short or long, and the resulting data type will be INET6, and it's automatically, character string counterpart is automatically converted to the INET6 data type. If it can't be converted, then you get a null result. Or alternatively, a 16-byte binary string, again, the resulting data type is INET6, and or null if it can't be converted. So, here's an example. We're selecting using the coalesce function, and the coalesce function returns the first non-null value in the list. Here's a null field, a null value cast as INET6, and here is a valid INET6 value cast as char. So in other words, this is now converted to INET6 and you'll get a valid result back. If you try to do the same thing, but now you're not using a valid INET6 data type, your result will be null with a warning because of the garbage at the end here. This cannot be converted to an INET6 data type. So I'll just show you what the warning is. Incorrect INET6 value. That's really as simple as all that. Now, if you are migrating from an earlier version of MariaDB, you would probably have had to do something like this. When you created your table to store INET6 values, you would have probably created binary 16. And then when you inserted, you would have had to use the INET6 ATON function to insert the value. And then when you retrieved it, you would have had to do the reverse with the INET6 NTOA function to get the result back. So not particularly difficult, but it's really a lot easier with MariaDB 10.5, and upgrading is as simple as altering the table and modifying the field from that binary 16 to an INET6 value. And now we can insert, as we showed earlier, and selecting is really as simple as that. No need for using the INET6 NTOA or ATON functions anymore. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Links to more information in the knowledge base are in the YouTube description below. Please subscribe to our MariaDB Foundation YouTube channel. Till next time.